I think it's a really good lineup. Really exciting lineup. Surprises in there. I'm really happy actually, because there were things I didn't predict. I always like it when, you know, people are a little bit shocked when they come out of the nominations. So yeah, there were some shocks in there, which is great. That's definitely the shock, the 11 nominations of Grand Budapest Hotel. I don't think it's because people didn't like it. I think it's just because it had been slightly forgotten. It came out, I think, sort of last springtime, 2014, and very successful, biggest Wes Anderson movie in the UK. But I think we all thought people had just moved on and they'd gone on to other things. And of course, traditionally, the awards kind of films start getting released around October and are still coming out now as we speak in January. So I think things from that early on last year, we just didn't expect to do so well. The fact that it has is the sign that it's actually really stuck in people's minds.
There are key categories that people look for, none more so than perhaps than best film. Can you walk us through our lineup?
Yes, well, we have Birdman and Boyhood and Grand Budapest Hotel and Theory of Everything and The Imitation Game. So you've got a couple of very interesting, I think, slightly more out there American films, indie films, really, certainly in style, if not actually financially, in Birdman and Boyhood. Grand Budapest Hotel is the front runner with the 11 nominations. And then you've got, I think, two films that people are sort of seeing as quite similar, really, and seeing as a bit of a face-off between the true stories of great scientific men. So you've got the Alan Turing story in The Imitation Game and the Stephen Hawking story with Theory of Everything. So for my money, it's between those last two. But I think it's very difficult to call. I mean, I've looked at that list a lot. I've tried to kind of spot one that I think is going to do it. But, they, you know, equally, any of those could really win, because I think it's a very tight race. I mean, Julianne Moore is obviously a great actress, and she could have been nominated for another film as well, The Maps to the Stars, which has come out. Actually, she was nominated for a film called Still Alice. But I think that it is always a problem, because a lot of these films do come out around the time of the nominations, or actually around the time of the actual awards as well. You look at a film like Whiplash, which has got Best Supporting Actor nomination, and people will see J.K. Simmons, they'll see Miles Teller and the E! Rising Star Award, and they'll go, well, I don't really know what that film is or who they are. But I think by the time the actual awards come round, people will definitely know who they are, because they'll have seen the film by then. But for my money, in the Best Actress category, I think it's Felicity Jones. I mean, it's a great performance by Rosamund Pike in Gone Girl as well, but I think Felicity Jones in Theory of Everything, because she holds the screen as well as Eddie Redmayne, who has the more, if you want to call it, the more flashy performance. But she is equally, I think, engaging in a tough role. It's a tough thing to actually share a screen with someone giving that kind of acting performance. So I think she'll win it for Best Actress.
Again, a very strong British lineup, both in the acting and the technical categories. Do you think it's a massive advert for the thriving success of the British ability to make films, not just consume them?
Yeah, it's a great advert for the British ability to make films. And we talked about Mr. Turner not getting perhaps Best Director, Best Picture, things like that we expected, but it did get technical awards, which it absolutely deserved to get. I think it really shows this year, or the 2014, the last 12 months, have been great creatively. I think perhaps box office analysts will say it wasn't the greatest year financially, but for my money, creatively, it's been a great year. I mean, look at like 71, for example, which has a couple of nominations, low-budget British film, Jack O'Connell again in the Rising Star Awards. You know, that's exactly the reason why we should be celebrating films, to celebrate films that perhaps not everybody saw or have heard of, but we go, this is great, go out and see it, get hold of it, watch it, enjoy it. That's what it's all about. I think it's important to celebrate the arts, because not everybody can do what we do. You know, they're not allowed to. Some countries, you can't do this kind of thing. You can't make films. You can't make films that are irreverent or critical in any way or thought-provoking in any way. And I think the fact that we can, we take for granted, probably, but it's at times like this, it's great to remember that we can do that, and it's a great time to celebrate that we can do that.